When you talk about the rank and file of the PIA, what exactly somehow hurt them or offended them? When you talk about the yeah. policies or changes that you introduced?
I suspended the rice subsidy in 2018. It was flagged by COA. It did not have any legal basis. So I was told by COA to stop the rice subsidy, and I obliged. And unfortunately, people have been receiving these additional benefits for several years, and they got hurt with these decisions.
How much was the rice subsidy?
It's 2,500 per month. 2,500 pesos per month.
Per month, and they had been receiving it for how long?
I believe for the past 5-6 years.
And it was flagged by COA, so
yep.
you suspended it.
Yeah.
So what did they do after?
Who?
The employees.
Oh, well, some of the people in FMD during that time, they were telling people, they were telling drivers, clerks, and everyone else, that COA already agreed on the rice subsidy, and I it was me who didn't want it. It's not true. So that's how the emotions are piling up. At the same time, I also prohibited receiving of pasalubong during travel, because every time people go to provinces, they would expect the regional office or the provincial office to give them things like lechon, candies, as cheap as candies to as expensive as lechon. And I didn't want that, because all of those are charged in government. And why would we receive pasalubong when we're just there to do our jobs?
So basically the money was moving from one pocket to another.
Yeah, so I prohibited that. And third, I prohibited the use of social media during work hours. We are a public information agency, and we do rely on social media. But the policy that I set, if you are not an official social media handler, you cannot use Facebook and Twitter in the office during work hours.
So you sound quite strict. So most likely you ruffled a lot of feathers within the agency.
Yeah. And I have my reasons. For one, I know some people are watching movies during work hours. They watch YouTube. So we suspended YouTube. We suspended Facebook and Twitter. And this is the same scheme that people are working. They created an anonymous Twitter account to attack me, since this is, I think, it began in March. On a daily basis, they would post things against me, telling the public that I'm so corrupt and I stole money and stuff. The primary reason is to really paint a very bad picture of me. I'm a very low-profile person. I never get interviews. I don't want to speak in public. But this time, I figured I have to go out.